We made it, friend. We are officially on video number 4, and you are amazing for hanging in there with me. And I hope that I have left the best for last, how to speed up your graphics creation process with Canva templates. I'm not just talking about the templates that you can find in the Canva template shop, although these will help you save time, especially if you don't feel like you have an eye for design. But I also want to put you fully in the driver's seat of being able to create the templates that you need in your business. Before I do that, let's go over why I feel creating templates in your business are so important. We use templates for everything else in our business that we do on a consistent basis. So think about canned email responses, or your blog workflow, podcast workflow, or maybe the template that you use to create your website, or the contract that you have in place on your website. These are all templates. Anything in our business that we do often makes sense for us to streamline this process. Why not have the same process for our visuals? I realized that I could save myself a lot of time and my clients if we had those go-to templates and we didn't have to start from scratch every single time. Having Canva templates in place in your business is going to help you speed up your creation workflow, post more consistently on social media, create more lead magnets or freebies or opt-ins and grow your list, and give you back valuable time that you can repurpose in your business. Not only that, but it's also going to help you batch create your graphics and create that brand consistency that you're looking for across all of your social media channels. So how do we break down creating your Canva templates in a way that feels totally doable? We do this by focusing on the 3 most important graphics that you need to master inside of your business. Those 3 graphics are the square, the stories, and the rectangle. These are the 3 most versatile graphics that you can easily repurpose with Canva Pro. Once you have them mastered, you can easily resize and repurpose them to create any other graphic or template that you need in your business. I'm going to show you exactly how to do that in this video. The first graphic that I suggest you master is the square. Now, the square is so incredibly versatile, not just for Instagram, but we can use it on Facebook, in our emails, and we can share quotes, testimonials, we can share tips, our latest blog post or podcast episodes. We can announce when we're going live, or even any promotions that we have running or content upgrades that we have to share. So I'm going to show you really quick how I take a basic quote like this, and I always recommend that you start with at least 3 variations of each design just to get started, and then you can grow and build on there. But I know this sounds intimidating, but I want to show you how easy this can be. So if we're going to take this quote and we want to batch out 3 variations of this, I could make a copy of this design. I could change out the background color. I'm using the contrast tip that I spoke and shared about in video number 2. And you can see if I used a dark color or black would stand out. If I used a different shade of red or pink, it might not pop as well. My goal is to pick up my brand colors, the ones that I think will stand out. And if it's relevant for you to have your website at the bottom, you can include that. In this variation, I'm gonna take the flowers out. Now I'm gonna do the exact same thing, but here I'm going to add a photo to the background. And I love this new feature where Canva immediately pops it behind my text. It sends it all the way to the back. In this case, I can go and pick another brand color and then bump down the transparency of the photo in the back. Now I have 3 quote graphics. That took me just a few seconds. And I'm going to repurpose this to create a testimonial story graphic. And what I'm able to do with Canva Pro is go resize Our dimension for the square is 1080 by 1080. So I go 1920, copy and resize. And we are going to repurpose this design into a testimonial. I'm going to add some quotes. Okay, so there we have our graphic. And now if I want to batch some of these, I can make a few variations simply by changing up the colors. Okay, so there we have 1, 2, 3 testimonials from the beautiful Crystal Clark. And I can also use this layout to create a tip post. I might have header, change out my text, add a photo. So now whenever I want to share a tip for the week with my audience, I can just repurpose this same graphic. And I can do that with or without these little flower icons. I can also change out the photo and the colors. And then I can use this same layout to promote an opt-in. And I always use these guidelines to make sure that I'm centering my text boxes where I want them. Now I have a testimonial, a promotion graphic for my opt-in, and also a tip graphic. And once I have one variation down, it's so much easier to repurpose that graphic into different variations or options. There you can see all of the stories graphics that I just created. And once we are happy with this, all we do is we resize, we change these dimensions around to create our rectangle. I do the exact same thing. I simply move my brand elements around and I start playing with this layout. Here, I want to move Crystal to the right side and my copy to the left. There is one option. Again, I'll just copy this guy and then repurpose it for another variation. And now I'm going to repurpose this tip Tuesday post in case I also want to have a Tip Tuesday on my Facebook page. And the easiest way for me to add a variation is to swap the elements around and add a different photo. We have our testimonial, we have our tip. Let's throw in a promotion graphic. It definitely helps to know ahead of time what you want to say on your graphics. So that would be my tip so that you're not spending your time trying to come up with clever copy and a clever design. I really feel like your brain can only do one of these really well at the same time, and even though your copy and or your design work might inspire the other, it's helpful to have your copy ready to go ahead of time. In this case, I'm snagging this copy right from my website. So it's already an opt-in right over here. Okay, so in this case, we have our testimonials, our Tip Tuesday, and also a promotion graphic. If I didn't want to include a photo of me, I could do this exact same thing and instead add a mock-up. Now I can repurpose this, a Facebook group graphic, a Facebook post graphic, a LinkedIn graphic, all I would do is resize it to the size that I want, be really clear about what it is that I want that graphic to say. But from here, it's so much more manageable to create those go-to templates that I need instead of starting from scratch. I can just build on what I already have created so that I don't recreate the wheel. Okay, so there you have it. There's the square, the story, the rectangle, and then from the rectangle, I already went ahead and created a banner graphic. In video number 3, I introduced you to Casey and her business and how she was setting up her Canva Pro account, but also taking the templates that she purchased from the Canva template shop and now integrating that with her brand. In this case, the 3 graphics that she was focusing on, again, was her square. So we started off with a testimonial, and what we did is we grabbed the concept for this from one of the graphics that she purchased in the Canva template shop. It was this graphic here that we moved the elements around a little bit, removing this, adding a different circle. So here you can see how this comes together. Then from here, we created some variations. The next graphic was the rectangle. We focused on a Facebook banner, again, by repurposing one of the existing templates from the Canva template shop, playing around with variations, and then Casey repurposed the Facebook header to create a course header. This is the one that Casey is busy playing around with right now. And then instead of focusing on a stories graphic first, which she could easily convert her square to that, she was working on a sale graphic from this square, which she can also repurpose into a stories graphic. But as a priority, she wanted to work on her checklists first. We went ahead and created this checklist layout for her by repurposing one of the checklists in the Canva template shop. And then from this one, she was able to create a new concept for a different worksheet. And then taking this idea and creating a horizontal version too. I hope that that helps to see how this comes together so that instead of trying to focus on all of the graphics at once that you need to create or that you've just purchased, you focus on your 3 most important graphics. You personalize them until you are happy, and then you see how you can take those graphics and resize and repurpose them. I hope that you love these tips and that you feel inspired to create your very own Canva templates. Now, if you all like this is wonderful, Nicolette, but I still want more shortcuts, I still don't feel like a designer, I just want my Canva account set up with designer templates, then I have you covered. The Canva template shop is filled with so many options for any single graphic project that you have going on in your business, and they all come with video trainings from me to guide you through how to set them up and get them personalized in just a few minutes. If these tips have helped you save time, headaches, or even a frustrated tear or two, I would love if you would share it and leave me a note in the comments below. I cannot wait to see how you put these tips into practice in your own business.